bacela kaKhumalo bangicela kaZungu bacela nakaShanti bacela ngobusuku benzela umfana na ngayicelela ke mina ngayikhethela wena kethile kethile.
My name is Siza Ndlovu. I am married to
Zondile Brian Ndlovu. I was born and bred in Soweto.
We've been together for 7 years. February will be turning 8 years.
But we've been married for 8 months. We actually met in varsity at the University of Johannesburg, Kingsway campus. At the D-Labs, a lot of people that went to UJ know where the D-Labs are.
It was end of the year and we were preparing for our final exams. So I was with two friends and because it was so empty, we decided obviously to sit anywhere, not sit together. I sat a chair or two chairs away from Umzwandile. But obviously I didn't pay him no mind.
I actually heard her communicating with her friends and that's where I picked up her name because they kept on calling her Caesar this, Caesar that. So I was like, oh, okay. So her name is Caesar. Then I was like, okay, hi Caesar. Then she gave me this weird look.
I was just like, hi. You know, I was like, dude, leave me alone.
When was the first time you found him attractive?
That very same day.
From the day I said hello to her.
I was upset that he was greeting me, but I wasn't too upset because he was cute.
I remember what she was wearing. I remember the black dress, the braids. I just remember all of that.
Later on that evening, I think that it was that evening or a few days later, I posted something on Facebook and then he sent me an inbox and he said, hi again, Caesar. I was like, oh my word, this guy, what the hell? And I didn't even know I had him on Facebook. I was like, this guy is so creepy.
We both don't remember who added who on Facebook because, you know, back in the days when you got Facebook, you just added whoever, be it celebrities, anyone around you, people that appeared on your suggestion list. You just added.
I think from then on, I responded like, hi. And then like he made conversation. We spoke via inbox for a while. Then he started like stalking me. Okay, he says he wasn't stalking me.
She actually claimed that I was stalking her. On campus, which I wasn't, but coincidentally I always bumped into her or always saw her on campus.
He'd send me messages during the day and say, oh, you look nice today, I saw you crossing the street today, oh, I liked that black dress. I was like, oh my, what's this guy? But eventually, because we had each other on Facebook, we actually had like a lot of conversations happening there and getting to know one another. And then he started like asking to see me on campus. He started carrying my textbooks for me, you know, the sweet love story you always see on TV.
And in 2012, we then made things official on the 25th of February, and that's when we started dating.
He was like, you're my girl. I was just like, yes, this is the one.
Fast forward to 2018, I then went on one knee and I proposed and I asked her to be my wife.
So we've been together ever since. And it's going to be 8 years in February 2020.
She's the love of my life. She's everything.
Uzwandi is a dream, guys. And I'm not saying this to so that you girls can want him or want to experience that for yourselves. No. But he's an absolute dream.
She loves me unconditionally. She She's honest with me. She's just everything, and she makes me a better person.
Uzwandi literally makes me feel like I'm the only girl in the world. As you guys can see, obviously, that I'm a plus-size girl, and obviously plus-size girls have a lot of issues in terms of the way that they look and having people that body shame them, etc. I've never really felt anything from Uzwandi in terms of, oh my word, I'm so uncomfortable around this guy, I don't know what to do. He's always made me feel really comfortable. And obviously it's a journey, like learning to love yourself and being plus-size and embracing your body. It's a journey, and having Uzwandi in my life has made that journey so much more easier. I've become an advocate of self-love and body positivity, and I think in a quicker space than most people would because of Uzwandi.
Being with her is just, you just want to have that moment for life. You just never want that moment to end. Whether you're with her through thick times, through difficult times, through good times, but you just want to keep that moment with her.
Must I ask?
Yeah, you can ask first.
Alright, must I ask you?
Ask me.
Name the top 5 things you love about...
About you. Top 5 things. The top 5 things I love about you, my angel, is your voice. I actually love your voice when you sing to me. You tend to sing to me. So I love your voice. I love your smile. I love your beautiful eyes. I love your toes. Guys, my wife has the cutest toes, so I really love my wife's toes. I just love your body and your confidence as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm trying to count how many was that.
I think
five.
I went to 6. And I could go on. Yeah.
Thank you.
Right. Here we go for it. When did you know you wanted to be monogamous with me?
I've never really thought of being in a relationship with more than one person. I don't think it's ever crossed my mind. I've always really just wanted... Also, I grew up in a Christian family, and we are Christians, you and I, so it's just always been like that traditional, it's okay. I'm gonna find a boyfriend, build with him, he becomes my fiance, then becomes my husband. And yeah, and Namandi, I don't think would ever go that route. It's not a consideration for me. I hope it's not for you as well. Do you ever get jealous if you see me talking to other attractive people?
No, I don't. I don't get jealous.
Why?
Because I think I know, I trust you. I know that you have the eyes for me only. And because of what we have as well, I don't get fazed by those type of things. But initially there was some form of jealousy, because it's normal to get jealous and all of that. But as we grew and as we became more matured, I've become more chilled and relaxed. And yeah. Okay. Do you think I have changed since we got married?
No, not at all. And I think that's the one thing about being married, and it's just like making your relationship the same from the start to the end. Like, don't change.
Yeah.
I don't think you've changed, and I really do appreciate that about you. You still have the same fun. You've changed in a sense, you're good to now. You have responsibilities. You have a wife to be responsible for. You have a home to be responsible for. So you've definitely stepped up and become responsible. It's not something I was able to see in the past when I was your girlfriend, because you weren't really responsible for me as your girlfriend. I held it down on my own. But now, you know, I'm able to allow my husband to take care of things. So yeah, you haven't changed, you've become more responsible. What are your secret thoughts when you see me at the end of the day?
My secret thoughts when I see you at the end of the day, that I almost said something very inappropriate.
Say it.
That I wanna get it.
Ha ha ha.
Oh my God. But yeah, after a long day, I'm like, you know what? If I can just get home, relax, and just, you know. But yeah.
Oh my God.
Next question. What is your favorite thing I ever did for you? A special occasion for you?
Definitely our proposal. My proposal. Definitely the day you went on one knee. Oh my goodness, I think it's the most romantic thing you've ever done for me. And then me seeing the pictures after of how you planned, how you went there with your mom and went there with the photographer to view the venue, just so you guys can see how the lighting is going to look, because you know me and pictures. So I think that's the most special thing. You've done a lot of special things for me. I don't remember what you said on that day. I was just waiting to say yes. But that was. What are the moments when you feel our souls connecting the most? Don't say when you get it.
Okay, apart from when I get it. But I think our souls connect the most when we go through a lot of challenges. I think we open up more to each other, we connect more. We live off each other's energies, because I know when you're not okay, I need to be strong for us. When I'm not okay, you need to be strong for us. So I think it's more the difficult times that connect us more and connect our souls more. And yeah, but obviously the fun times as well and the things we enjoy doing really connect us. Do you see our love lasting?
Yes, definitely. Oh, that's like the biggest and most easiest yes I have. Last but not least. You want more? What can I do to make sure you feel safe with me?
What can you do?
I feel like you should have asked me that.
Probably.
Okay, but answer.
I think in just loving me, continuing to love me. I think keeping my heart as the pinnacle, or keeping my heart as your core motivation to keep me protected. I think just protecting my heart, not physically protecting me, but I think protecting my heart is, and just continuing loving me. That's how you'd make me feel safer. And yeah.
I think if I were to answer that question, especially with a lot that's happening in our country right now, what you can do to make me feel safe is continue obviously doing what you're doing now, protecting me, putting me first, etc. But also I just feel like we had said in our previous video, calling out your friends, making sure that the people around you are doing what they're supposed to be doing, because the crisis that our country is in, and the thread that we saw on Twitter of people expressing themselves about certain people that have violated them. It's people that we know.
Yeah.
Excuse me. People that are close to us, people that are close within our circle, and it's very scary to see Uti people have the ability to do that. So calling out your friends, making sure Uti your circle of friends are good, and obviously reaching out to people that need help as well. But also I just feel like if we all call out our friends, then we're all good, and if we all make sure we go to the circle around us is good, then everyone is going to be fine, because there's a lot going on, and I just feel like it's high time the crap stops.
Ching chong chong. Two season kizi ndlovu sithando sam. I just want to start off by saying thank you. Thank you for loving me and ensuring that your love is honestly felt. Often at times we claim to love, but the love we give is never seen nor felt. But yours, my love, has been warm, has been fun, has been tough, but most importantly, has been unconditional and deeply felt. My love, you're a beautiful and witty woman. I've seen you grow from strength to strength in your social life and in your career. And I still can't thank God enough for issuing me a front row seat to your life journey. The challenges you have overcome with and without me in your life remain a true inspiration to me. And that is why I say, Wimbo Ward. And these are just a few reasons why I will forever consider you a priceless gem in my life. To finish off, I just want you to know that as much as you give me headaches from time to time and become a typical annoying wife, I will always hold you high. I will always value you. I will always, always love you wholeheartedly. You have become the reason I breathe, and I would not trade that blessing for anything. So as our beautiful journey continues, let us continue to make God the center of our love. Let us continue to value what love is, and let us continue being homies for life. I love you with all my heart. From Zwandile.
Okay. Oh, am I gonna read this now? I really should have got thrilled. Zwandi. Okay. Zwandile Brian Dlov. Gajen Wam. Boya Binyat. My sweet, sweet baby. Where do I even begin? Firstly, let me be honest and say the first day I saw you, I never ever would have imagined that you'd be my husband today. And that is exactly why I believe that our love was definitely written in the stars. When God made you, He definitely had me in mind, because you are way beyond what I could have prayed for. A God-fearing man, the sweetest and most kind, educated and the smartest person I know. Let's not forget Funny, my very own comedian. Look, I could go on all day, but I'll stop here for now. Thank you. Thank you for loving me literally unconditionally. Thank you for always making me feel like I'm the only woman in the world. Thank you for respecting me, protecting me, and just being a dope best friend. You know I thank God for you every single day, because firstly, I can't believe He gave me such a stunning looking man, but also the most amazing soul. I simply cannot wait to start a family with you. I can wait, but I can't wait, you know what I mean. Continue being a dream, my dream, and I pray God continues to bless us in abundance in our journey ahead. I love you, Boopsie.
I love you. Sure. Those onions.
Chopping onions.
Yeah,
no. No, I'm not crying. You're crying.
I think I have something in my eye.
I got you. Okay. Yo, what's happening, YouTube?
Hi, guys.
Thank you so much for watching our defining episode.
Yeah, thank you guys for watching.
Yeah.
And don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to Defining.
Yes.
And yeah.
I think don't forget to comment, guys. Let us know what you thought of the episode. And you can find us on Zwandile and Siza on YouTube. Zwandile and Siza on Instagram. Siza Mkize, Mkize with no H on Instagram.
And Mzwandile Ndlovu on Instagram as well.
Mzwandile Ndlovu _ on Instagram. Thank you so much. But
thanks, guys, for watching. We thoroughly enjoyed. Thanks to the Defining team. Thanks to everyone.
Thank you to Dennis and Bongani.
Yeah.
We really had a great time with you guys. You made us chop onions.
Yeah, a lot.
It was good. It was good. Even Zwandi cried.
Yeah.
But yeah, guys, we'll see you guys again on this channel very soon.
Yeah, guys. picture of AJ.